Hello everybody, good evening. We are here for our most awaited session that is part of a career development program, Swayam Ek Khoj. And today we are going to have the first session about becoming a voice actor. And I'm so happy to see you all here. If you are watching us right now, type your name in the chat section and we'll surely try to welcome you suitably. Share the link of this video with your family members and friends and help them join the session right now. We are going to have experts from the industry of voice acting and who are going to share their knowledge and experience with us. You will be able to ask questions and share your thoughts through the chat box. So who all are watching us right now? We have 38 people who are watching and one of them, okay, Varun is here, Vicky Kumar, we have Maulik Panchal, we have Pokemon fans, we have story time, okay, the voice land, we have Chandrika Goel, we have Shashank, okay, who all are watching us right now? We have Marlin, we have Chirag, who else is there? Thank you so much. Oh, we have Payal Vishal who is joining us here, we have Ankita, we have okay, there's so many people here. Thank you so much to everybody for registering for this particular session. We have got 71 people watching us live right now. Let's make it 100. Share it with your family members and friends and ask maximum people to join this session. I'm sure you'll find something really important and relevant over here. And this would be a wonderful experience being part of this session today. We have, we have Rohan, Karishma, Krishna, Jia, Robin, we have Adarsh, we have Jia, we have World of Magical Voice, Aryan Chauhan, then the Voice Land and Robin Hood team. Okay, Ami. Hi, Ami. Thank you so much, everybody, for being here. We have Rajesh, we have Himank. My goodness, there's so many people. We have made it to 88. I'm waiting for making it 100 and then we will start with the sessions. Thank you so much everybody for being here. Let me introduce myself. I am Nancy Shah. I'm a trainer, public speaker, anchor, voiceover artist and founder of Speaker Circle. Speaker Circle is basically an initiative through which we help people develop public speaking skills. We conduct our interventions online and now gradually offline. You just need to fill up a Google form to be part of our WhatsApp group and learn and explore ourselves into the field of public speaking. Subscribe this YouTube channel because the entire program Swayam Ek Khoj is going to happen over here live starting from today for next 4 days at 7:30 p.m. every evening. Today is the day one where we are going to have experts from voicing industry. Tomorrow, the second session is about how you can become an RJ, where we are going to have RJ Parima here with us. On third day, it is about storytelling. We are going to have Ms. Geeta Ramanujan over here to talk about it. And on the fourth day, we are going to have Sonam C. Chhabra. She is an anchor who is going to talk about how you can build a career as an anchor. This is career development program. It is completely free. It's on online and we have got more than 700 registrations by now. Thank you so much for overwhelming response. Share it with your friends and family members and ask them to join. And yes, subscribe this channel so that you get regular updates about all the programs here. Apart from the sessions, we go live on this channel every Thursday where we do storytelling, movie review, book review, poetry recitation, knowledge sharing session and much more. And guess what? All of them is completely free. So you'll get something really important to learn over here. With this, I think we have got 107 participants watching us right now. Thank you so much, everybody. Let's begin with the session today. I'm able to see so many people commenting in the chat box. We'll go through the chat box throughout the session. We have already rolled out a Google form in our WhatsApp group. जिन्होंने भी WhatsApp group join किया है, उनको हमने एक questions भेजने के लिए बोला था. सबने Google form fill up किया है, उसमें से हमने questions shortlist किए हैं. And we are going to talk today about the voicing industry and how you can build a career as a voice actor. And to talk about this, we have not one, not two, but the three legends of voicing industry. Let me introduce them one by one. Our first speaker today, or the first panel member today, is somebody who has started his career in 1985. He has started his career in the voicing industry at the age of 7. Yes, I am talking about Ankur Zaveri, sir. Ankur Zaveri has dubbed over 100 films and have done over 1,000 commercials and 5,000 channel promos. You must have seen the commercial starring Virat Kohli. He has been the official voice of Virat Kohli for more than 12 years now. And he has been doing this amazingly. He's one of the founders and the ex-president and ex-vice president of the Association of Voice Artists. And he's going to share relevant information that might help you be part of this association gradually. His notable works are Jack in Titanic, Goku. He's famously known as Goku in Dragon Ball Z. He has also given a voice for Fast and Furious for the character Paul Walker. He is the voiceover artist for the Star Sports, Hotstar, Z5 and TV and so many other things. So many people does not know that he was a child actor initially. He has acted and he has been a child artist for various movies also. If I ask him one thing, then he said, every day you should wake up as a struggling actor to strive harder. This is his philosophy. We are so happy to have you, sir, over here. Thank you so much, Ankur, sir, for accepting our invitation and being here. Our second speaker or second panel member today is somebody who has an experience of 35 years into this field. Yes, I am talking about somebody who is famously known as Chichi. Do you understand whom I am talking about? Well, she is none other than Neshma Chimburkar. She has been a stage actor and dubbing artist from age of 5. She has been a banker for 7 years and also worked as a TV news anchor, done many Marathi plays and more than 10,000 recordings. My goodness. Not only this, she has won various awards from different organizations in this field. Her best projects include Black Widow from Avengers, Queen Elizabeth in the Netflix series The Crown, The Haunting by Blair Manor, Chichi from Dragon Ball Z, that is what I already told you. Apart from that, she has given a voice for Mystery in Pokemon, The Blossoming Powerpuff Girls. It's like we have known her from her voicing while growing up through various cartoon characters. She learned this art from her mother and has passed it on to her kids as well. They are also the voicing actors and now training people in this industry to explore themselves into this field. Thank you so much, Neshma ma'am, for agreeing to come over here and being part of this wonderful session. We are so happy to have you. And our third, and of course, one of the speaker today is Sanket Mathur, sir. He has been in industry for more than 15 years now, have voiced more than 150 Hollywood movies and over 300 South Indian films. My goodness. He has voiced characters by Ryan Reynolds, Matt Damon, Brad Pitt and Chris Evans. His work in animation includes Penguins of Madagascar, The Croods, The Green Legend, Frozen and so on. Do you remember the Bear Grylls from Man vs. Wild? It was again his voice in Hindi. Not only that, he has voiced many projects in Discovery and National Geographic. The famous character Ben Zan was voiced by him. The list goes on and he extends his several audiobooks, commercial, radio shows, Netflix movies and series. He is also, he has received various awards in the industry. And if I start talking about all three of them and their qualifications and what they have done into the industry, I think 1 hour would be less than the time. So let me stop here and let me invite them for the session. Are you all excited for it? Give me a thumbs up if you are here watching us right now. We have got more than 136 participants watching us right now. This is going to be a mind-blowing session which will talk about how you can build a career as a voice actor. If you want your family members or friends or like-minded people to attend this, you can share the link directly with them. And with this, let's have all three of them here with us right now. Welcome, Neshma ma'am. Hello, Ankur sir. Hello, Sanket sir. Thank you so much. Hi. For joining in here. We are so happy to have you.
Thank you so much for having us, ma'am.
This is an amazing evening where all three of you have come together for this session.
You're looking amazing, Nancy. I hope we make this program as charming as you are.
Thank you so much for inviting us. And this is a really great initiative. I'm really loving this and so excited to be a part of this. Thank you so much for inviting us.
Thank you. Thank you so much for being here, everybody. Now let's begin with the actual talk. Okay, so why we are organizing this particular session? To spread awareness. I think not all of us knew that you can also become a voice actor. This can also be a career option. Your voice can also spread magic, spread awareness, and it also has a strength to empower people. This is a field which is now coming into limelight gradually, and now people are getting aware about it gradually. But I'm sure this would not have been the case when you started this career, and it is still the same with many people who are looking forward to become a voice actor. So very first question that I want to ask you, what do you think about voicing industry in general? I would ask this question to Ankur sir first, and then Sankit sir and Nishma ma'am, you may also add something to it. So what is an overview of voicing industry, or how does it work?
So of course, voicing industry, as is, you know, we guys are always behind the scenes. So like rightfully you said, you know, that nobody really knows as to who the voices are. And, you know, it's just now due to social media and some of the YouTubers taking this forward of, you know, showcasing as to who the voices are really behind those faces. So, abhi aisa ho raha hai ki log jaan rahe hain ki kis character ko jo wo barson se sunte aa rahe hain, uske piche ki awaaz kaun hai, you know. तो पहले तो ये इनफैक्ट होता था कि हमारे साथ कॉन्ट्रैक्ट्स भी ऐसे हुआ करते थे कि हमें डिस्क्लोज नहीं करना है कुछ भी अगर हम लोग डब करते थे. यहाँ तक कि मैं जो फिल्म बॉलीवुड हिंदी टू हिंदी, लाइक यू नो बॉलीवुड हॉलीवुड फिल्म का इंग्लिश टू हिंदी राइट, बट बॉलीवुड यू नो देयर आर सो मेनी ऑफ दीज व्हिच यू आर सपोज्ड टू नॉट डिस्क्लोज दैट आई एम डबिंग फॉर दिस हीरो.
So, yeah. But then currently the industry, I think Sankit sir, Nishma ma'am, you also have a rich experience in the field. How do you see a future of the voicing industry?
I think the future is great. Yeah. Yeah, Sankit, continue.
Please go ahead, Nishma.
No. See, the thing is, now that people have come to know about this voicing industry and everybody is loving this industry so much, I think the future is great. But yes, I would like to tell everybody that please have patience before entering this industry. Aisa nahi hai ki aap raato raat ekdam hero heroine ban jaoge. So please have patience. But yes, there's lots of scope here, of course. And it's an amazing industry. You will love it and you will never leave it also.
Thank you. Yes, Sankit sir.
Essentially, this is something I say to everyone when they talk about what is the voicing industry about. Voicing industry is all around you. I mean, it's just a matter of observing where it falls in place. You pick up your phone and call ICICI. The voice you're hearing during, you know, before you reach the operator is a IVR done by a voice artist. You're sitting in an aeroplane, your safety messages are voiceover artists. You know, you're listening to the radio, the commercials are voiceover artists. So we are all around you. But like Ankur said, we are in the background. And the industry is it's coming of age. Social media has kind of immensely helped. The one thing that I like to tell people is it can absolutely be a full-time career. There are three people sitting in front of you who made it a full-time career. A lot of people think of this as a supplementary thing. Main job karunga, weekends pe voice artist banunga. Or there are some who are like, this is a transient stage to get to me being an actor. Woh banne tak ya rent bharna hai, toh I'll be. But you know, the thing is, if you like doing this, and if you give it enough time, it becomes a full-time profession. There are people who are sitting in front of you with 35 years of experience in the voicing industry. I mean, so that speaks for itself. If you give it enough love, you can make it a full-time career. You don't have to look elsewhere.
Yeah, probably you start small, but once you establish yourself, but then you should start with a vision to make it a full-time career, not just for the sake of doing it for a couple of years.
That's what Nishma said. You need to have patience. That's the most important thing. That's what she said, right?
And also,
yeah, of course, you need to wait for 35 years to be what you.
No, it's not that.
After 35 years, you become a legend. You need to wait for the initial couple of years to, you know, put your foot in the industry.
Okay, that's all it is.
No, trust me, Nancy. Trust me. There are some who make it within 10 years, and there are some after 35 years also who are still trying to find a foothold like me.
That's so sweet of you. That's so humble of you. But everybody knows who you are. Okay. So the next question that I want to ask all of you is, probably Sankit sir first, that what are the skills that somebody needs, or what are the qualities a voice actor should develop gradually to be successful in this field?
A lot of it depends on what you want to do into voiceover. So it's a very huge thing when we kind of delve into. But if you're talking about, say, voice acting for films, or be it actually anything else, the primary thing that is required, according to me, is the language. If you don't have command over the language that you're going to voice in, be it English, Marathi, Hindi, Telugu, whatever it is, then it's going to be a major issue. Your language should be the most important thing, and the voice is something that you then start working on gradually. Working on your emotions through maybe theater workshops, or watching other voice artists, watching even film actors for that matter, delivering a particular scene. These are all secondary things according to me. But I think primarily, aapki bhasha kitni saaf hai, ye bahut zaruri hota hai. Especially in a language that you want to voice in. And it may come as a surprise, but a lot of us don't even have that kind of command over our mother tongues, let alone another language. True. So that is the
in
most
fact,
important
I think
thing to develop.
We are mixing up languages now. We are not able to speak right. One language clearly. Zyada time ke liye, hum automatically usme, jaise abhi main bol rahi hu, usme bhi kuch English words aa jaate.
I think people here are commenting ki please aap Hindi mein bhi bolo, because most of them are.
Hum Hindi English dono language rakhte hain
abhi bolne ke liye.
तो अभी आजकल एडवर्टाइजिंग में आजकल एक और लैंग्वेज जो बनी है वो है इंग्लिश.
इंग्लिश
हिंदी और इंग्लिश दोनों मर्ज हो गई है वैसे.
काफी बार जैसे मैं जानती हूँ कि आप में से काफी लोग हैं जो अलग अलग लैंग्वेजेस में वॉइस ओवर्स करते हैं, तो आप नया लैंग्वेज सीखते हो, उसके लिए पढ़ाई करते हो, क्या हाउ डू यू ट्रेन योर सेल्फ, आप किस तरीके से अपने आप को ट्रेन करते हो कि आप अलग अलग लैंग्वेजेस में भी अच्छे से, चाहे वो आपकी मदर टंग नहीं है, फिर भी उसमें अच्छे से डबिंग कर सको.
See, अगर एड्स हम कर रहे हैं तो वी यूजुअली डब इन डिफरेंट लैंग्वेजेस, लाइक आई माई सेल्फ आई डब इन हिंदी, इंग्लिश, मराठी, गुजराती, फोर मेन लैंग्वेजेस. दो आई एम नॉट अ गुजराती, आई एम अ महाराष्ट्रियन, बट येस गुजराती अच्छे से बोल पाती हूँ, बिकॉज आई डिड माई फर्स्ट स्टेज, यू नो, थिएटर वॉज इन गुजराती. मतलब अपार्ट फ्रॉम डूइंग मराठी प्लेज, आई डिड ऑल्सो इन गुजराती, सो आई कैन रीड गुजराती वेरी वेल. एंड अदर लैंग्वेजेस अगर बोलो, जैसे साउथ लैंग्वेजेस हुए या बंगाली, there are supervisors who are there to help us, of course. And I think you should have that thing in you to learn those new languages, you know. It's always better to learn new languages, to learn, you know, that learning process should be there always. Aaj after so many years also, we are still learning, I feel. There are supervisors to help you, there are other people also to help you. So, wo ho jata hai. But agar aap mein wo seekhne ki kala hi nahi hai, to aap nahi kar paoge. But agar aap seekhna chahte ho, to yes, any language is, I mean, not difficult. You can do anything, I feel.
So first thing first, get a grip over the language. आपको जिस लैंग्वेज में एंटर होना है, इट्स नॉट रिक्वायर्ड कि आप हर एक लैंग्वेज में डबिंग करो, हर एक लैंग्वेज में वॉइस ओवर करो, पर आप जो भी लैंग्वेज में करना चाहते हो उस लैंग्वेज पे आपका ग्रिप हो, प्रॉपर प्रोनंसिएशन
होना चाहिए,
हाँ
समझ होनी चाहिए उस लैंग्वेज की. सी एड्स तो होते हैं एक एक लाइन, या यू नो अप टू वन मिनटर्स, बट अगर आपको मूवीज करनी है डब, या यू नो जैसे सीरीज करनी है, तो वो लैंग्वेज, जैसे संकेत ने कहा कि लैंग्वेज का नॉलेज होना इज वेरी वेरी मस्ट, सबसे पहली बात यह है. क्योंकि कभी कभार ऐसे भी होता है कि स्क्रिप्ट गलत आ जाती है, यू नो इट इज़ नॉट ट्रांसलेटेड करेक्टली, तो वो आपको पता होना चाहिए, बिकॉज अल्टीमेटली पीपल विल हियर योर वॉइस. किसी को ये नहीं समझेगा कि राइटर ने गलत लिखा है, सामने वाला ये बोलेगा अरे नेशमा ने गलत बोला है. सो यू शुड ऑल्सो बी एबल टू जज कि अरे जो लिखा हुआ है, जो मैं पढ़ रही हूँ, वो सही है या नहीं. सो लैंग्वेज की समझ होना तो बहुत जरूरी है ही.
एनी एक्सपीरियंस आप में से किसी के साथ हुआ हो कि एक बहुत ही छोटा सा एरर था, जब आप डब करने गए, उसको बोलने गए, तब आपको समझ में आया कि दिस डज नॉट मीन व्हाट दे वांट, एंड यू सजेस्टेड एन इंटरव्यू.
I'm sure all of us are jumping right now to say yes.
No, I remember this very well. Why? Because it was Dettol ki ad thi, and I was going there. I went there for Marathi, and the script was, you all must be knowing Ankur since you do VOs also, Dettol ka, ki Dettol jo mare 100 bimari phailane wale kitanu. Ye line hoti hai, right? डेटॉल जो हमारे सौ बीमारी फैलाने वाले कीटाणु, मराठी में इसका ट्रांसलेशन था डेटॉल जो मारतो आजार पसरवणारे शंभर जंतु, मतलब जो मारे बीमारी फैलाने वाले सौ जंतु, मतलब सिर्फ सौ जंतु मारेगा क्या? नो, दिस लाइन इटसेल्फ वाज रॉन्ग. डिड यू अंडरस्टैंड? मतलब आप समझ रहे हो मैं क्या बोल रही हूँ? जो ये साबुन मारे सौ बीमारी फैलाने वाले जंतु शुड बी देयर, बट इंस्टेड लिखा था कि ये मारे सिर्फ सौ जंतु. मतलब 101वां जंतु आया तो क्या, वो नहीं मरेगा. सो द लाइन इटसेल्फ वाज रॉन्ग एंड आई सेड, एंड अफसोर्स देयर वाज नो सुपरवाइजर, आई सेड सॉरी आई कैन नॉट से दिस लाइन, दिस इज एब्सोल्युटली रॉन्ग. कल तुम लोग बोलोगे ये क्या बोला है मीशमा ने. सो स्टिल द एजेंसी गाइस वाज नो 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 डू इट टेक अ सेफ्टी. आई सेड सॉरी, ये जो गलत है वो गलत है, वी कांट डू दिस. तो आई सपोज अंकुर के पास भी काफी ऐसे एग्जांपल्स होंगे.
लाइक There's this veteran, senior, Gurudev, जो भी आप शब्द यूज करना चाहें, ब्रिजी, ब्रिजभूषण साहनी जी. तो ब्रिजी हैज बीन लाइक, जब हम दूरदर्शन ईरा में थे तभी यू नो हिज वॉइस यूज टू रेजोनेट ऑन एवरी चैनल एंड एवरी हिंदी कमर्शियल वॉज ब्रिजीज वॉइस.
सो
ऐसी थोड़ी थोड़ी चीजें, छोटी छोटी चीजें हैं जो हम डे टू डे लाइफ में भी यू नो वी डोंट कीप इन माइंड. जैसे आप कैसे हो, कई बार हम लोग बोलते हैं अरे आप कैसे हो, यू नो वी एंड अप सेइंग दैट, बट ही करेक्टेड एंड ही सेड के अगर आप कह रहे हैं तो इट शुड बी हैं, इट कैन नेवर बी
आप कैसे हैं.
सो आप कैसे हैं, नॉट हू
हैं, इट्स है नहीं है विद अ बिंदी हैं.
सो
दैट इज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग एक्चुअली.
या वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट.
सो इट दी स्मॉल लिटिल थिंग्स, इवन द क्रिएटिव हु वाज प्रेजेंट ओवर देयर, अ सीनियर क्रिएटिव was not aware of it. Even small little things like if you see silsila mein, agar aap wo gana dekhe, dekha ek khwab to ye silsile hue, you know that, then Javed Akhtar ji ki ek pen ki ad hai jisme he's endorsing a pen, zindagi hai to khwab hai, so it is written as khwab, correct? But can you believe it that we all didn't, I knew this just two years ago is when I corrected myself, it's actually khwab, it's not khwab. So oh, there's still so much of learning.
Yeah, you know, yeah,
and so
absolutely.
Like Neshma said initially, you need to be a good listener and you need to have that passion to learn and keep thinking that no, I'm not reached, you know, I'm still learning and I you know, I still want to educate myself more about this craft and language.
Yes.
True. And so it's like never ending process. Even if you have mastered this art and you've been doing it for more than 30 years or 15, 20 years, still there's something new that you might come across. Always. And we have to keep that learning mindset always as a voice actor. Because the requirements are different. Each project is totally different from
absolutely.
The other one.
Yes, right. Absolutely. We have to keep updating our skills also, you know, every day. It's very, very, very important.
So that's my next question.
Nancy, at the same time, Nancy, it's very imperative that we do not make ourselves as actors or voice artists sound slightly arrogant in the studio, you know, because kai baar aisa ho jata hai ki creative ko aisa lagta hai are main janta hu tu mujhe, you know, you're challenging my knowledge. So that is a very fine line which we, you know, need to humbly get over. Like jaise words like khoobsurat, many times, you know, many of them say ki wahan pe gale ke mein kharash aa rahi hai, so you have to explain to them that is khoobsurat spoken that way, ye kharash nahi hai.
The right thing, that is our responsibility. At the end of the day, what they like is the final thing, but then we need to suggest what is suitable.
Yes.
So we give two options. Script option.
Safety is what we have.
And most of the time, the first option is the final one.
That's the first take. The first take is always the correct take.
I understand, but no, ye dil mange more, kuch aur.
Thoda aur, thoda aise, thoda waise, wo chalta hi rehta hai.
True. So the next important question that we have, how to develop a good voice by, and what are the things that one should practice in their day-to-day life to develop a good voice? Who would like to answer this question?
I'm okay. Asking. Because next time I just spoke, let Sankhya take this, yeah.
Yeah.
The thing is, a lot of people consider their voice to be you know good or bad, and you know, a lot of people come from the come from the school of ki my friends have told me or my family members have told me that I sound really good, I should be a voice artist. Essentially speaking, this was a myth that I had that everybody should sound like an Amitabh Bachchan, for example, when I entered the industry. And you know, there are a lot of voice artists who try to add on this bass when they are speaking, or you know, it happens, it's a very natural thing. Hame lagta hai ki bahut bass voice ho to wo bahut achhi hai. And that was a myth that got broken for me as well. Aur ye bahut logon ke saath hota hai, because you realize that every voice is important. If you've heard of commercials from Paper Boat, I forget her name now, but so she has a very textured voice, the voiceover artist, and it's a very different voice. And you know, out of context, you would say your voice sounds, you know, really weird or something. But how beautifully she uses it, you know, that's the whole idea. So, you know, calling your voice a bad voice or a good voice, according to me, is the most, you know, the biggest mistake you could do with your own voice. The way to go about it is to pick up skills that you could use to improve your voice. The most basic of which is breathing correctly. जो सबसे बड़ी और सबसे बेसिक चीज है वो हम गलत करते हैं बहुत लोग. सो व्हेन वी आर ब्रीदिंग वी नीड टू इनहेल, वी हैव टू यू नो पुश आवर डायफ्राम आउट, उसका उल्टा कर देते हैं. व्हेन वी आर ब्रीदिंग वी पुश आवर स्टमक इन, एंड यू नो, सो दैट्स कंप्लीटली रॉन्ग. सो ब्रीदिंग इज वेयर इट स्टार्ट्स फ्रॉम.
व्हाट इज द राइट वे ऑफ ब्रीदिंग? सो
कंसीडर योर डायफ्राम एज अ बलून. व्हेन यू इनहेल, द बलून हैज टू स्वेल अप. सो व्हेन यू आर इनहेलिंग एयर, योर स्टमक हैज टू जट आउट, योर डायफ्राम हैज टू गेट ब्लोन अप. You know, that's the correct way of inhaling. So when you're trying to deliver a long line or longer passages, breathing from your diaphragm not only helps in, you know, delivering longer lines, it also helps in improving your volume. It helps in maintaining your voice over a longer session. So diaphragmatic breathing is very important. Hum bahut throat se breathe karte hain, nose se karte hain, bahut shallow breathe karte hain. So that is, you know, what the first step I would say towards getting a better voice.
There's a way to check it. You can put your hand on your stomach and your chest, yes. And when you are breathing, aap jab saans andar lete ho, tab aapka stomach expand hona chahiye. Yes. If that is happening, then bahut sahi cheez hai. Agar wo nahi ho raha hai, matlab you are breathing shallow and you can improvise upon that. Yes, sir, please.
So, just to add to this is, of course, as far as the texture of the voice is concerned, तो पहले शुरू में बहुत सालों पहले ऐसा एक नोशन हुआ करता था दैट अ डीप बैरिटोन हैवी वॉइस इज एन अथॉरिटेटिव वॉइस. तो स्पेशली इन कमर्शियल्स और एनी ऑफ दीज मूवीज द रीजन व्हाई दे वुड वांट दैट हीरो टू हैव दैट यू नो क्या रे तू क्या समझता है आपको यू नो दोस कैन दैट टेक्सचर वुड बेसिकली एसेंशियली बी के यू डोंट वांट योर हीरो टू साउंड मीक or look meek in front of a villain who's probably more hefty and more muscular or whatever it is. You know, the same goes for endorsing a product. Let's say your product voice, you know, the product window jo hota hai end mein jo aata hai har commercial ke, to wahan pe wo jo uski authority hogi ya uski ek glistening bhara, you know, twacha ki nami lota hai, us tarah ka agar hoga to maybe that has more conviction. That was the notion earlier. As we've come a long way, now if you notice most of the commercials also and a lot of the characterization which are done on OTT platforms for heroes and stuff like that are very next door kind of
very casual.
If you look at that possibility, there's a lot more opening now for newcomers who do not essentially have those typical deep baritone voice. However, saying that, ye zaruri bhi hai ki acha bhi hai ki agar baritone voice ho aur agar aap hey kids I'm a kid Navino wo bhi agar kar sakte hai to aapki range badi hai.
Yes,
so what essential as a voice artist ye हाँ, तो एज अ वॉइस आर्टिस्ट ये एसेंशियल हो जाता है कि सिर्फ बैरिटोन में मत फंसिए, यू नो, आपकी रेंज अगर होगी तो आपको और काम मिलेगा, यू नो,
पर इसके जरूरी नहीं है. वन क्वेश्चन हियर, हाउ टू फाइंड योर रेंज, लाइक दिस इज लिटिल टेक्निकल, बट ये सबसे बड़ा क्वेश्चन होता है कि मेरा एक्चुअल व्हाट इज द वैरायटी दैट आई कैन डू विद माय वॉइस, हाउ टू फाइंड दैट.
तो अब मेरे साथ तो ये हाँ, मेरे साथ तो अगर लिटरली लाइक यू नो कहते हैं ना कि व्हेन द रैट इज अगेंस्ट द कैट यू नो तो ऑल इट हैज टू डू इज लर्न टू हाउ टू जंप एंड यू हैव टू जंप यू नो. तो मेरे साथ ऐसा हो गया था, ऑडिशन पे गया था, मुझे पता ही नहीं था कि ये एनिमेटेड कैरेक्टर का वॉइस टेक्सचर क्या है वगैरह. एंड दिस वॉज द फर्स्ट ऑडिशन बैच केप्ट बाय यूटीवी इयर्स अगो. सो व्हेन आई वॉज लुकिंग एट दिस वॉइस आर्टिस्ट इनसाइड द रूम संकेत, यू नो, आई वॉज स्वेटिंग एंड आई वॉज परस्पायरिंग. आई वॉज लाइक कि हाउ इज दिस गाय डूइंग इट, मैं पीछे से ऐसे निकल जाता हूँ, भाग जाता हूँ यहाँ से, बिकॉज यू नो इट इज नॉट माई कप ऑफ टी. But somebody caught hold of me and said, hey, come, you know, why don't you come and audition? So zabardasti mujhe audition karna pada. And I got the part. I don't know how. Wow. So sometimes it's trial and error. You learn along the way. But for you guys, it's not so difficult like what it was for probably Neshma and me. Ke hamare paas, you know, VHS tapes wagera, you know, video recording ke tapes se. Aap logon ke paas YouTube hai, which is like the biggest asset you all have of checking different voice textures, looking at international voice artists, looking at Sanket Matre's clips and whatnot. You know, if he teaches, Neshma teaches, you know, all of you all teach online also. You know, it's brilliant. It's so easy access for you all, you know, so you all can learn all these things online. But you all should be able to be a good listener first.
You know, I'll say for, you know, I always say, ki listen, don't listen, you see with your ears. आपको देखना चाहिए अपने कानों से. मतलब यू इतने जितना अच्छा आप लिसनर रहोगे उतने ही अच्छा आप मॉड्यूलेट कर पाओगे. सो यस, बी अ गुड लिसनर.
सो ऑब्जर्विंग इज अ वे टू लर्न. आई थिंक
ऑब्जर्विंग इज वेरी मच एसेंशियल फॉर मॉड्यूलेटिंग वॉइसेस, प्लेइंग डिफरेंट कैरेक्टर्स. देयर आर सो मेनी कैरेक्टर्स अराउंड अस, बच्चों से लेकर बूढ़ी नानी दादी आंटी. यू नो दैट राउंड वॉइस, क्वीकी वॉइस, थिन वॉइस, ये वॉइस वो वॉइस, ये सब हमारे आस पास होते हैं. तो ये ऑब्जर्व करना बहुत जरूरी होता है. लाइक इन एड्स और रेडियो स्पॉट्स बहुत बार ऐसा होता है कि वी आर टोल्ड टू डू डिफरेंट कैरेक्टर्स. जैसे अभी से रेलवे अनाउंसर या काम वाली बाई है, ये तो हमें ये याद रखना चाहिए कि अच्छा वो काम वाली बाई आएगी मेरे पास तो कैसा बोलेगी, इसी तरह से बात करेगी ना, भाई आज मैं नहीं आने वाली, या रेलवे अनाउंसर कैसे. तो यू हैव टू रिमेंबर दैट, यू हैव टू कीप ऑन,
यू हैव टू गेट इनटू दैट मूड,
यस दैट जोन, यस यस यस. सो व्हाई इज दिस फील्ड कॉल्ड वॉइस एक्टिंग? दिस इज नॉट ओनली अबाउट वॉइस, इट इज एक्टिंग. यस, द नर्व रसास, द 9 इमोशंस, वो पहले अपने आप में ढाल लो एंड यू कैन टर्न आउट टू बी अ ग्रेट वॉइस एक्टर. अगर गुस्से में बोलना है तो वो गुस्सा अंदर आना ही चाहिए ना. अगर रोना है, अगर कोई इमोशनल सीन है तो या वी लिटरली क्राई व्हाइल डबिंग अ इमोशनल सीन. या वी डू दैट, होता है हंसते. तो ये कला है एंड आई फील इफ यू आर अ गुड एक्टर ये वॉइस एक्टिंग अपने आप आ जाएगी. आई फील एवरीबॉडी इज एन एक्टर. हम बचपन से एक्टिंग करते हैं, मम्मी
ड्रामा कहीं जाना है,
हाँ तो सब ड्रामे पास होते ही हैं. तो ये नेचुरली है ही अपने आप में, बस उसको थोड़ा और निखारो उस कला को और जरा और थोड़ा मॉड्यूलेट करना सीखो. एंड बस, नो वॉइस इज गुड वॉइस और बैड वॉइस, इट्स ऑल अबाउट मॉड्यूलेशन. या इट्स ऑल अबाउट मॉड्यूलेशन एंड हाउ यू इनएक्ट प्रॉपरली.
So, okay, one more question to Sanket sir specifically. How you can practice different voice modulation? Like how you can practice it every day? You must, do you guys do something every day or once in a week to practice? वैसे आपके तो recordings ही इतने होंगे कि उसमें
I was just going to say that. we kind of end up practicing on the job only because we end up doing so many recordings. But coming to your question about modulation, so when people say modulation, it essentially means there are certain sub factors to modulation. Things like what is your pace, how loud you are, what is your pitch, what is your tone, and you know how much you're pausing. These are some factors which constitute modulation. So मैं आपसे ऐसे भी बात कर सकता हूँ और आप शायद समझ नहीं पाएंगे कि मैं क्या बोलूँ, या फिर मैं ऐसे बात कर सकता हूँ और मैं जहां मुझे जरूरी लगता है वहां पे मैं एक पॉज ले सकता हूँ, जिससे उसके बाद जो मैं कहूंगा वो आप अच्छे से अब्सॉर्ब कर पाए. तो देयर आर थिंग्स दैट यू कैन डू विद योर वॉइस वेयर आई कैन गो लाइक दिस एंड आई कैन टॉक टू यू लाइक दैट और आई कैन इवन कम क्लोजर एंड आई कैन ट्राई एंड टॉक टू यू लाइक दिस. तो हर सेंटेंस जो आप बोलते हो उसमें ये 5 फैक्टर्स होते हैं. इट्स योर स्पीड, योर टोन, मतलब मैं कौन से इमोशन के साथ बात कर रहा हूँ, मैं कहाँ पॉज ले रहा हूँ, व्हाट आर द साइलेंसेस इन द सेंटेंस. And that is how you master modulation, is you master these 5 elements. You naturally, जब हम बात करते हैं, हम में से कुछ लोग fast बोलने के आदी होते हैं, हम में से कुछ लोग general neutral pace होता है, कुछ बहुत slow बोलते हैं, कुछ बहुत loud बोलते हैं. So these are things that we need to be aware of first before we start off on this journey of modulation, कि मैं naturally कैसे बात करता हूँ. And then you have to break that pattern. As a voice artist, I have to go inside a studio as a ball of clay and then look at the character and then mold myself. As a voice artist, I cannot be myself as a inside this. Like as Sanket outside with his friends is like, kya yaar, kaise chal raha hai? And also, but I can't be like that when it's a serious character. So I have to kind of neutralize my face, cut down whatever I've been doing all my life and make it into a neutral, and then go inside and check what the character is doing that day. It might be angry, it might be emotional, like she said, I might have to cry. It might be speaking really hurriedly because it's excited. So those sare chote chote factors, jab aap control karenge, that's how you modulate your voices. It's really quite simple when you break it down into the factors.
I have one more question here. Any of you can answer this. How do you mark up the scripts? Do you do any markings before you record it? How do you practice? Like, most of the times you must be getting script in advance, and sometimes there is on the spot also. How do you manage that?
We have to. We always pause markings karte hain hum log.
Now, wo kaise karte hain? Wo kya hota hai?
एक तो सपोज इफ यू आर डूइंग एनी डबिंग ऑफ एनी कैरेक्टर, तो एक तो पायलट होता है, तो वी हैव टू सी कि जहाँ जहाँ वो रुका है वहाँ पर एक पॉज मार्क करो, जहाँ जहाँ पर उन्होंने ब्रेक लिया है यू हैव टू सी कि हमें भी वहीं पर ब्रेक लेना है. ये हुआ उस डबिंग के लिए. अगर हम से अगर रेडियो स्पॉट कर रहे हैं जहाँ पर देर इज नो रेफरेंस, मतलब देर इज नो पायलट फॉर अस, वी हैव टू डू इट. ओरिजिनल एनिमेशन कर रहे हैं या रेडियो स्पॉट कर रहे हैं या इवन ऑडियो ड्रामा कर रहे हैं या ऑडियो बुक्स कर रहे हैं, तो वहाँ पर फिर हमें अकॉर्डिंगली ब्रेक्स लेना पड़ेगा. जैसे संकेत ने अभी कहा कि यू कैन स्पीक कंटिन्यूसली ऑल्सो और यू कैन टेक ब्रेक्स इस तरह से कि मैं जो कह रही हूँ आपको समझ पा रहे, तो इट्स ऑल अबाउट दैट. और उसी हिसाब से हमें जो स्क्रिप्ट पर वी जस्ट लाइक यू नो स्ट्राइक एक ऐसे लाइन छोटी सी करते हैं एंड वी जस्ट मार्क द पॉजेस दैट वेज.
ओके, सो इट्स इंपॉर्टेंट टू गो थ्रू द स्क्रिप्ट एंड रीड इट कपल ऑफ टाइम्स, मार्क द पॉजेस इन एडवांस सो दैट वंस यू गो इनटू द स्टूडियो यू सेव टाइम.
Yeah, we don't
you're very lucky if you've gotten a script before you've gotten to the studio. That almost never happens. Like 99% of the time we are in the studio and then you are given the script, you stand in front of the mic and read it for the first time
and
so like
directly.
I said
directly,
most of the time. This is true for films, this is true for ads, for everything. Most of the times, even after you reach the studio, the script is not arrived. It arrives after some time after you reach there, so even they're reading it for the first time and then you're reading it for the first time. So it always happens that, and this is why it's more important that you set your foundation correct before you try and become a professional voice artist. So, if your reading is good, if your command on language is great, you don't have any issues with creating an emotion on the spot, then you're not worried so much about what will be there in the script and you're not panicking about it. When you read the script for the first time, you read it calmly and then you operate. And that's how all of the artists do. Because like I said, I really doubt kisi ko pehle script milti hai.
Yeah, agar audio book kar rahe hain, toh shayad
book, that's a different thing. Correct.
There's a lot to read.
Reading 600 pages before my session, that's not happening.
So Nancy, sometimes
question. Ankur sir.
No, so as in what happens is, hum wahan pe on the spot ja rahe hain, to of course ek do baar rehearsal ko karne milta hai, as per, just to see the timing and mark the pauses and all that. Like hum to pause marking ki baat kar rahe hain, kai baar aisa ho jata hai ki ek line ke baad agar full stop hai, to character ne wahan pe pause liya hi nahi hai, to hume to wo full stop kabhi kabhi hatana padta hai to say the whole two lines in one flow, kabhi kabhi ulta bhi karna padta hai. And underlying,
well, especially dubbing.
Yes, especially doing character voices, because one benefit which voiceovers have is ki they have a longer duration of fitting the words the way they want to. And which is the liberty which unfortunately character voices don't have
it
in that duration. So yes, many a times I have a lot of fan dubbing friends, on Instagram sending me a message that, see sir, maine itna acha kiya hai, abhi main kya, can I go out there and can I get work? So main unko yehi kehta rehta hu ki see, you've done one scene. Not trying to discourage, but I'm trying to just make them understand that don't take this craft for granted. That you've done this one scene sitting at your home, on your home setup and everything, and you have probably taken 10 days just to practice this one scene, and you nailed it. You've done a good job. But when we are at the studio, like Sanket said, like Neshma said, we have four episodes to finish within 3 hours because the next artist is scheduled within that much time. In that duration, we have to laugh, we have to cry, we have to yell, we have to do everything, and we have to be bang on with our performance, That pressure is a very different thing. So, it's a lot more of mental strength also got to do and mental aptitude to do with our field also.
Not only that, I mean, if you are doing ad and there are several people sitting, four creatives sitting, each having his own opinion.
Okay.
And we have to do a project for each and every one of them. Kabhi aisa karo, waisa karo. That's what I said. So it becomes very difficult. So
actually, the reality, we have to face the reality and understand that doing something on your own for practice is totally different than the actual scenario that you need to face in the studio, and you have to prepare yourself for the same. This brings me to the next question, and I want to ask this to Ankur sir especially. What are the different types or different genres of voicing industry? Like, people know that you can do dubbing, people know that you can do ads, people know that you can do cartoon animated characters. But I am sure there must be many more things than this. Would you like to share a few?
But do we have 5 minutes or 2 minutes rather? I'll try to wrap it up in 2 minutes.
So yeah, 2 minutes.
You know, at the association level, when I was the vice president, we had tried to see there were so many facets of voicing. We really didn't know ke किन किन कैटेगरीज में वॉइसिंग हो रही है और तभी 10 साल हो गए थे हमारी यूनियन को बने हुए और तभी एक लेजेंडरी लेजेंड है मतलब आई कैन कॉल हिम द एम्परर ऑफ द वॉइस इंडस्ट्री कॉल्ड चेतन शशितल एंड ही एंड आई सैट डाउन लिटरली वी टुक अबाउट 2 months टू यू नो जॉट डाउन एवरीथिंग एज टू व्हाट कैटेगरीज है सो आई जस्ट ब्रीफली जस्ट रीड थ्रू सो दैट इन केस इफ एनीबडी सीज दिस रिकॉर्डेड राइट सो पीपल वुड हैव एक्सेस टू दिस So, of course, see, there's advertising, which has TV and digital commercials. There are radio spots. There is a thing called animatics, narimatics, and scratch recordings, which are presentations done, presentation jobs, which go to the client of the different genres of advertising. Ke usme se wo log select karte hain ki kaun si ad ke upar wo paisa kharch karke final commercial banayenge. So these come under advertising. Then there are corporate films. There's video van publicity, there's rural van publicity, there's telemarketing, infomercials, product demo films, pesticide and farmer-oriented films, documentaries and AVs, like you see it on Discovery. I think Sanket is already doing something commendable there. Discovery, NGC, Animal Planet, and dramatization of news events, interactive websites, CDs, DVDs. Gaming is a big thing now. In-house training programs, audiobooks. Then comes channel voicing. In that you have promos, recap announcements, जो शुरू में आते हैं show के शुरू में एक recap होता है वो. फिर behind the scene videos होते हैं, उसमें भी एक voiceover होता है. Then there are TV and web series like live action and animation. You know, you have animation also happening, you have live action also happening. You have documentaries, episodics for different seasons and solo episodes, independent episodes on OTT platforms. On radio, you have radio jockeys. You have sponsored programs which are drama based. You have award functions mein, you have pre-recorded narrations, each category announcements. You have telephonic prompts. You have IVR, which is IVRS. And you have in-flight. Flight mein jab aap baithe to in-flight announcements happening. In cinema, you have not just animation and live action films, but you have commercials playing there also digitally. And overall, in this entire gamut which I mentioned to you, you have main characters, you have supporting characters, you have incidental characters, you have ambient voicing. So, पीछे भी जब आप crowd वगैरह सुनते हैं, उनकी भी एक special dubbing पूरे 5-6 लोग मिलकर के, 10 लोग मिलकर के, दो-दो shift वो लोग dub करते हैं films वगैरह के लिए. And of course, there are narrations. So that is how big this voicing field is actually. You know.
I think we are everywhere. If you look around, everywhere you'll find somebody has dubbed something, somebody has given voice to something.
So of course, it's a huge field. It's huge.
Yeah, it's such a huge field.
Yes, and depending on what you feel you're cut out for, what you have the passion for, what you see yourself doing 10 years from now. ऐसे नहीं होना चाहिए कि चलो experiment कर लिया 2-3 साल तो minimum देने पड़ेंगे आपको field को. Like, you know, there's an old saying, na, ke 1,000 din dene padenge kisi bhi ek craft ko ya ek business ko just to see whether you
10,000 hours. Correct. Yeah.
Correct.
So, the very same way, if you give good amount of time, only then you'll know whether it's working for you or not. Whether you see yourself doing it 10 years from now also or not, then you should get into this.
So, this brings me to the next question. Like, how somebody should prepare a voice sample? What should include there? Let's say I am an aspiring voicing artist. I want to approach studios. I want to start getting work. Then how I should frame my voice sample? What sort of variety it should have?
Sanket, you want to take that?
So honestly speaking, what Ankur said just now is there's an important point in there. You know, out of these, you know, umpteen number of categories, what excites you? So once you zero in on what excites you, if it's, you know, dubbing for films or if it's animation, for example, then your sample should definitely have that as the highlight. Okay. Secondly, it should cover the languages that you can voice in. For example, if you voice in English, Hindi, Marathi, then your sample should essentially have those three languages. You can either make three different sets or you can have the three languages as part of three pots inside that sample. If it's about animation, if you could include, try and include like a clip of the animation and your voice over the clip. That helped people get a better understanding of how it will look on a screen. Unless, of course, you're trying to, you know, pitch for a radio spot or something of that sort, then, you know, it could be an audio clip. If it's a television commercial, look at television commercial, pick up the videos from YouTube, voice over them, and then, you know, place them in your sample. So whatever it is that you want to get into is what your sample should encompass. It should have the language that you can do, and it should have the vocal range that you can cover. And that is very important because they should know what are the voices you're capable of producing. And in spite of having all of this, it should still be very, very short and concise. Nobody
has the timeline for the same.
Correct.
Like it's
each sample should never exceed like a minute. Minute is also very high. I would say 30-40 seconds is the maximum people are going to hear it. Unless there's something that is very engaging in the script. Ki main sun raha hoon aur mujhe maza aa raha hai, then it's okay. I'll probably hear it for a minute. Other than that, people are hearing these samples. They are being sent and bombarded with these samples, especially studios where voice banks are collected. The people who are hearing them are hearing a lot of them every day. What is it that that separates your voice to them? Or what is it that will make them sit up and say, oh my God, I've never heard this. Or, you know, oh my God, this was really funny and such a great voice. Let me. So your sample script also should be engaging because you're only going to get 30 seconds to make it.
So how to develop a good sample script?
It's quite easy. What is the television commercial that made you sit up and say, this is so funny, I love this commercial? Or what was the, you know, the animation clip that you saw and said, oh my God, you know, this act, you Goku, how cool does he sound? I want to be like that. Pick up that clip. What excited you is something that will excite someone else. So it's
so
quite
you need
easy
to curate your own script. You need to curate your own script. You need to curate your own sample of 45 right. seconds to 1 minute in a manner right. that it creates a differentiating factor for you right. because that's the entry level, no? That's right. the base from which somebody will invite you or right. ask you to do the work.
Think of it as your job interview, basically. So you've done your, you know, your education is complete, you've built up your foundation, and now you're going in for this interview. And that interview may, unfortunately, you are not going to be present. You are just going to submit your CV and come out, and somebody else is going to read it in privacy and they are going to make a judgment about it. You know, so it has to be impeccable, which is why I always suggest at least give yourself 6 months to a year before you approach a studio and provide a sample. Because if they don't like that sample, they're not going to call you back. Yeah. Work on yourself for 6 months to a year, get perfected in, you know, in terms of the kind of voice artist you want to become, and then make that sample. That making that sample is a process in itself.
Okay. So rather than hurrying, take time, prepare yourself before you launch yourself into the industry.
Yes.
Right. Practice will make you perfect.
Which is what, you know, many who end up doing those fan dub one scene, you know, which is what Sanket is trying to emphasize on, is that what happens is you end up doing that one scene of that one character. And you think that this is what I'm nailed. Now
nailed
I can
it.
Go and meet a studio person and say, mujhe hero ke liye lo up, you know? But that is not how it's going to work. Because there are
Correct.
So many out there who are doing it day in and day
right.
out. So like Sanket said, what is it that yours will make that person
Your
stand out?
Differentiate.
So you need to have at least two, three different samples which showcase you as a hero voice. You know, potential
so adding to Ankur's point, so there is this example that I often give people is of this guy called Lohit Sharma. He used to make YouTube fan dubs. So whatever films would come out, he would make the trailer voices and he would voice for all the characters. And they would be starkly different from each other. And he kept doing this for a year, for 2 years. I don't know how long he was at it. Finally, somebody noticed him. Platforms like India Voice Fest came up. You know, people in the industry heard the trailers and they thought they're really funny and they couldn't believe that one guy is voicing for him. And now Lohit Sharma is actually working in the industry. He's working on Netflix shows. He's working on documentaries and Discovery shows. Wow. And he's a part of the industry. And, you know, he was just, he kept at it. He kept doing what, he didn't think that kal main jaunga aur main approach kar lunga kisi ko aur mujhe kaam mil jayega. You know, you have to, aapko karte rehna hai. And you don't have to think about when you're going to crack it. You know, that's not the point you should be thinking about.
Exactly. Build your profile first. Build your profile. Build eligibility. Profile. Build Correct. Skills and Correct. Right mindset so that once you get an opportunity, you nail through it.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
That's and, really and, important.
And Nancy, it's also like many have this fixation. I remember Sanket and Neshma might agree. Like our dear friend Mona Ghosh Shetty, who has this very big you know, studio and company called Sound and Vision. So once in her show, which is called the Mona's Magica, she had mentioned that everybody comes to me and just talks about doing a hero or a heroine, you know, and it doesn't work that way. Even be it like Neshma or Sanket or Ankur Jhaveri or anybody, we've all graduated slowly, you know, yeah. Like my kid who's a 6-year-old is going to be in the first standard next year. Now he wants to be in college, you know, he's like, Papa, when will I be able to do that fight sequence or whatever? You can't, because you have to graduate slowly. In his mind, he's already reached there, you know.
Correct.
But it is all about that. So it's very essential for you to not just target that one voice texture, to have that range. You'll have that range, you'll get some penetration, you know, possible in the industry. Buy something, then you keep learning, and then you'll probably reach somewhere. You know? But don't be in a hurry.
Don't be in a hurry. Have patience.
Have patience.
Patience, yes.
True. Okay, once I have my voice sample ready, how should I start approaching the studios, or how should I get a work? How does the industry work?
I'm guilty of hearing one of Sanket's 3 minutes to a better voice regarding this, and I know he has an answer ready for this. I remember seeing that episode as to how to...
No, you online. Tell me.
Most of the students, like,
right.
And most of the people have the same question. This is most crucial when that I have developed the skills gradually. I have my voice samples, but how do I start?
Show up. You know, the two important words are show up. Just turn up at the studio, write emails. You know, try and get their numbers off Google, you message them politely, ask them if you can send them samples, ask them if they have a voice bank. There are certain studios who have annual, open auditions. There are some who audition from project to project. Until you show up and they know you're on the radar, nobody's going to call you. You know, ask them politely, where can you send the samples? It doesn't matter if your samples are not selected when you send them the first time, send them the next 100 times. People have got their work rejected 1,000 times before they made it big. You cannot expect that, you know, your sample might be the most brilliant one in the universe. It depends on who's listening to it and if they think it's brilliant. So, you know, always show up. Just keep at it. Take your samples, move around, find what studios are in your city, find what work they do, write an email, call them if they're close by, visit them, you know, make sure they see your face, make sure they hear your samples. And that's the only way they're going to remember you the next time a project comes up. Arey yaar, wo ek ladka tha, wo aata tha, you know, wo sample deke jaane ki baat karta tha, just see if you have his number, you know, call him. Because you were there again and again, they remember. And I'm not saying again and again, like unki window ke bahar jaake khade ho jao and scare them, you know, into not, you know, putting you off the premise. Don't do that. But be polite every time you approach them, and, you know, reminders bhejo, be it a month, be it 2 months, whatever it is, because it's a huge industry. It's already functioning. And by that, I mean there are already artists in place who are working. So you are going to have to, you know, displace a cog and put it elsewhere and then fit into it. It's a huge process for somebody who's been voicing with a certain voice bank for years to, you know, be open to a new voice. It's very difficult. And there are a lot of studios who do this graciously, but there are a lot who are comfortable with what they have and they're okay with that. So to be able to change their mindset, you know, you have to just show up. Take your work, take your samples, and like I said, build them over a period of time, then make your samples, make sure that your first impression is your best impression, and then show up. Yeah.
Very cool.
Are there any online platforms or sites or anything that you suggest where you can submit your samples and get connected? Because there's so many people who are not in a metro city, who are not living in Mumbai probably, or the hub of voice acting, but they are at some other place and they want to approach studios over different states.
So I used to tell people that maybe, you know, 10 years ago, ये एक एक्सक्यूज हो सकता था कि यार मैं, you know, छोटे शहर से हूँ या इस गांव में रहता हूँ और मैं कुछ नहीं कर पा रहा हूँ. बट अब ये एक्सक्यूज नहीं हो सकता. दिस इज नॉट समथिंग यू कैन से टू पीपल. इंटरनेट से पूरी दुनिया, यू नो, आपकी जेब में है. देर आर लॉट ऑफ वेबसाइट्स, फॉर एग्जाम्पल देर इज freelancer.com, देर इज वॉइस बनी, देर आर टन्स ऑफ वेबसाइट्स. इफ यू जस्ट पुट अप कि मैं वॉइस वर्क एंड दे वर्क ऑन अ बिड सिस्टम वेर यू नो यू सेंड योर सैम्पल्स फॉर अ प्रोजेक्ट एंड इफ द क्लाइंट लाइक्स इट यू गेट पेड. यू माइट गेट पेड इन डॉलर्स, यू माइट गेट पेड इन पाउंड, यू माइट गेट पेड इन रुपीज, डिपेंडिंग ऑन वेयर द क्लाइंट इज फ्रॉम. And there, your barriers and your, you know, the only barrier then would be to deliver a good quality recording. That's all. Agar studio, and this is a good example now because pandemic ke dauran, hum sare artists bhi hamare ghar se recordings kar rahe the, bahut sare.
None
of us physically went to a studio. So ye ab mindset bhi open ho gaya hai to a lot of studios ki haan, theek hai, do lines hain, agar wo achhi quality ka bhej pa raha hai sample, then we have no issues. Do it from there. Yeah. A lot of channels are encouraging this. They've not opened their studios. They're saying, you're sending us good quality work. We are completely fine with it. तो अब ये बैरियर ही नहीं रहा कि मैं भोपाल में हूँ या नागपुर में हूँ या यू नो किसी गांव से रिकॉर्डिंग कर रहा हूँ. गांव से रिकॉर्ड करके आप टिकटॉक और यूट्यूब के स्टार बन सकते हो, तो आप वॉइस आर्टिस्ट क्यों नहीं बन सकते? देयर इज नो लिमिटेशंस नाउ एंड देयर इज नो एक्सक्यूजेस आइदर.
वेरी ट्रू. यू आर पोस्टिंग एवरीथिंग ऑन सोशल मीडिया, यू आर रिकॉर्डिंग एवरीथिंग. जैसे वीडियोस बना सकते तो ये क्यों नहीं हो सकता? डोंट पुट अ हर्डल ओवर देयर. दिस इज अ वेरी कॉमन थिंग दैट पीपल हैव अ बैरियर एंड दिस बैरियर्स आर मोस्टली मेंटल, नॉट एक्चुअल. सो इफ यू ब्रेक दोस बैरियर्स, यू विल बी एबल टू कम आउट ऑफ इट.
करेक्ट.
Okay, so how to set up a home studio or how to record something at home? Yeah, Neshma ma'am, if you would like to share.
I'm you know, right now I'm in my recording box, if you can see. Can you see this?
Yeah.
So yes, thanks to this lockdown and this pandemic that we got our own recording boxes and home setups done. Otherwise, we were running from one studio to the other. So yes, it's quite easy. I mean, just take your and sometimes so I dub from my iPhone also. Okay. So just, I mean, it's quite easy. एक छोटा सा बॉक्स बना लो. आई सपोज मैंने तो हरीश भिमानी जी से ये देखा है, उनके पास था. आई यूज टू गो एंड रिकॉर्ड देयर इन हिज हाउस इन दिस बॉक्स. एंड आपके पास अगर लैपटॉप है, एक अच्छा माइक है, हेडफोन है, देन बस गेट अ नाइस सॉफ्टवेयर. ऑडेसिटी अगर लेना है, इट्स वेरी इजी टू अंडरस्टैंड. और मे बी आई डू इट फ्रॉम नुएंडो, जो मैंने सीखा है. एंड we are doing it from home. It's so nice and so easy. Again, I said learning process jo hai, to yahan par hum khud recording karna seekh gaye hain. And it helps us so much. Like today I went to a studio after 2 years and that security guard was like, "Arey, ma'am, aap kahan thi?" I said, "Main ghar se record kar rahi hu, kyun main aaun studio?" So this pandemic was really helpful for the voice industry, you know. Sare industry thap hui thi, lekin sirf voicing industry chalti rahi. We didn't stop. हमारा काम चल रहा था दिन रात हाँ, बिकॉज घर से तो 24/7 ही कर रहे थे. रात को 3 बजे भी उठ के वी आर रिकॉर्डिंग. ये था.
So you using this, so you need a laptop, you need a microphone, you need a headphone, and you need a good software through which you can have a basic editing in your voice. And you suggest Audacity, and which one, other one?
Nuendo.
There are many Nuendo. I am doing on Nuendo, but there's Reaper and many, many more.
Are these free softwares or we have to buy
the paid
one?
Audacity is the free one.
So yes, this is a good recommendation. Anybody who wants to set up a home studio can download and set Audacity and use that. You will surely find video tutorials on how to use Audacity on YouTube. You can explore and learn through that and start applying it to your home studio.
आपको ताज्जुब होगा ये जान के कि बहुत से होम सेटअप्स जो हैं आज की तारीख में, जो बहुत से एस्पायरिंग वॉइस आर्टिस्ट के घर पे ऑलरेडी एग्जिस्टिंग है, द काइंड ऑफ क्वालिटी दे आर कमिंग आउट विद 10 years अगो, यू नो, इवन व्हेन वी हैड प्रोफेशनल स्टूडियोज, they were not churning out that kind of quality the way the kind of quality is being churned out now. So it's a big boon, big advantage to many of these aspiring voice artists ke agar achhe videos dekhenge, achhe tutorials dekhenge aur seekhenge, 100% they'll know the way out, you know.
Definitely.
Yes, true, true. Everything is open now and we have the opportunity to do anything that we want. The next question I have for you all is, what are the things that we should avoid eating or how we should maintain our throat before voicing? Do you take care of few specific things in your day-to-day routine? See, Vinesh Baba is laughing, I am foodie. Pata nahi kya bolungi isme. Is there any parameter or is there anything that you suggest?
No, I just avoid cold stuff. Bas, I avoid cold stuff. Matlab, though I love eating ice creams and all, but agar main khau bhi, toh I see to it that I take a glass of normal water or lukewarm water, just to keep my throat normal. Because zyada thanda khake phir gala jata. And you know, Mumbai mein itni dust hai, pollution hai. I stay in Chembur, the most polluted area. So continuously we are having those allergies. You know, so medication to chalta hi rehta hai. एंड ये कंटिन्यूस बातें कर कर की रिकॉर्डिंग्स घर से डे नाइट करते करते इट स्ट्रेन्स योर वॉइस. यू नीड टू हैव दैट प्रॉपर 8 hours स्लीप, दैट ब्यूटी स्लीप ऑफ योर्स टू मेंटेन योर वॉइस. खाने के बारे में एंड आई थिंक ऑयली स्टफ अगर थोड़ा कम करो तो इट विल हेल्प यू. बाकी तो आई ईट एवरीथिंग, तो मुझे कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं. बट नो,
व्हाट अबाउट यू सर?
सो टेक्निकली इफ यू मीट एनी ईएनटी ना, so he's going to, whenever a voice artist, I don't know if it's happened with any of you all, it's happened to me a number of times, whenever you meet an ENT aur aap kehte hain ki main voice artist hu, to then they ask you ke kitne ghante kaam karte hain aap, matlab kitne ghante studio mein. The moment they get to know ke 8-10 ghante to hum karte hi hain regularly, they are like, are you mad? This is a tool which is supposed to be used only for communication. You're abusing your throat, you know. But hum voice artist pe work pressure bolo ya jo bhi ho, itna zyada hota hai. So as it is, maine zyadatar notice kiya ki kafi voice artist ko na thoda sa wo, you know, zyadatar rehta hi hai, because we all are overusing our vocal folds, you know. And many of these studios, like abhi to of course thankfully most of them are very conscious, but there are lot many studios who are not keeping their studios clean or hygienic. So there are things like dust mites also. So now, depending from each person to person, what allergies you have, what suits you, what does not suit you. There have been many people who eat oily stuff, who have an ice cream very easily, but nothing really affects them. But there are some who are just very far away from a studio sound engineer, who's probably really far and smoking a cigarette, let's say, you know. But उस 10 मीटर दूर है फिर भी कुछ लोगों को स्नीजिंग शुरू हो जाती है वगैरह. सो आई वुड सजेस्ट कि नो योर बॉडी टाइप, यू नो ईच बॉडी टाइप इज डिफरेंट. ऑफ कोर्स चाइल्ड आर्टिस्ट जो भी होंगे उनके लिए उनकी मम्मीज जानती होंगी कि इस पे क्या सूट हो रहा है क्या नहीं, बट ईच वन ऑफ अस आई थिंक मोर ऑर लेस वी नो व्हाट वर्क्स फॉर अस, व्हाट डज नॉट वर्क फॉर अस. सो अकॉर्डिंगली ये तो पता ही सबको कॉमन नॉलेज है कि ऑयली वगैरह जो है तो यू नो जस्ट टू अवॉइड दैट ड्यूरिंग ईटिंग. I mean, during recordings and all that. But yeah, basic thing, know your body type. You know, and
okay. Sankit sir, you want to add something here?
So warm water is your best friend, first of all. So sone se pehle, subah uthne ke baad, just have warm water, you know, carry a bottle of water if possible, keep having small sips of water. The two right. things that dehydrate your throat really badly, which are coffee and cigarettes. So just before a session, avoid these two. I'd say avoid cigarettes as much as you can at all, because there's also this myth ki cigarette se bass voice badhti hai, and there's a lot of artists also who fall into that thing. But you know, it's a myth. Please don't smoke.
Aisa kuch nahi hai.
सेशन इन चीजों को आप अवॉइड कर सकते हैं. पोस्ट अ सेशन लाइक शी सेड, यू कैन ऑलवेज गो फॉर एन आइसक्रीम. देयर इज नथिंग, देयर इज नो रूल्स टू दिस. द रूल्स आर लाइक अंकुर सेड, नो योर बॉडी. यू नो, मैं वॉइस आर्टिस्ट हूँ तो मैं बिल्कुल नहीं खाऊंगा, या मैं मुझे कुछ होता नहीं है तो मैं 5 आइसक्रीम खा जाऊंगा. दीज आर जस्ट एक्सट्रीमिटीज. यू नो, स्टे अवे फ्रॉम द एक्सट्रीम्स ऑफ एनीथिंग. जस्ट यू नो, एंजॉय इन मॉडरेशन एंड इट्स ऑल गुड.
Yeah.
True. So know your personal body preferences, your type, what are the things that suit you. Like there are few people ki jinko weather change hote hi shardi ho jati hai, zukham ho jata hai. To aap un cheezon se dur rahiye jo shardi ya zukham karte hain. To aapko apne body ke physic ke hisab se kuch cheeze decide karni padegi. Kuch logon ko, like I personally really love drinking milk. To mere liye before I go for the recording, I have a glass of milk. I feel energetic.
नॉट ओनली मिल्क, मिल्क विद हल्दी, आई विल से मिल्क विद टर्मरिक, मतलब ये दवाई होती थी.
हाँ, मतलब ऐसा रूल नहीं है कि भाई स्टूडियो में जाने, रिकॉर्डिंग से जाने से पहले मिल्क आइटम नहीं ही खाना चाहिए. इफ इट सूट्स यू, इफ इट यू, इफ यू आर फाइन विद इट, इफ यू आर कंफर्टेबल विद इट, गो फॉर इट. बट डोंट डोंट अवॉइड व्हाट सिग्नल्स योर बॉडी इज गिविंग यू कि भाई अभी खाने दो ये चीज. ट्रू ट्रू ट्रू. ओके, नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन दैट आई हैव, how to keep getting work regularly and how to negotiate for the rates of different work. Now, why I'm asking this question, because each day you have a different client, each day you have a different project. Of course, once you establish yourself into the industry, you'll get a regular client, you'll get regular work that is there for you. But then as a beginner, you have to find your clients because they don't know that you exist at all. So how to keep getting the work regularly and what are the prevailing rates and how should we negotiate with that?
I think Ankur can help us with the rates because he was the rates, wages.
So this is one question which I decided I'm not going to answer on at all. Is because don't want to...
It's a huge thing, I think.
And not just that. My main thing was like, okay, let's say आप गाड़ी आपको गाड़ी सीखनी है, आप 18 प्लस हो गए, अडल्ट हो गए हैं, आपको गाड़ी सीखनी है, ओके, आपको लाइसेंस चाहिए, तो सबसे पहले आपको 100% वो लाइसेंस अगर चाहिए तो यू विल हैव टू पुट दैट एल प्लेट, जो लर्नर का जो एल प्लेट होता है, करेक्ट. सो दैट इज द सेम थिंग विच आई वुड लाइक टू से, बिफोर यू वॉन्ट टू अर्न, लर्न,
लर्न,
जस्ट फोकस ऑन लर्निंग फर्स्ट. Do not get into this any of these aspiring voices. I would want to say the way, rates will keep fluctuating. The industry is becoming better, but certain sectors, you will not believe it, there was one time where advertising was right here, you know, and film and serial dubs were, you know, probably as far as parameters are concerned and money spends are concerned and marketability, etc., was, you know, this was the scale. But more or less things, you know, keep fluctuating here and then depending on how the whole field is working, you know, and how the clients are putting, pumping in money, like with OTT platforms and all that. So, kaam badha hai. So, my, you know, 2 cents to over here would just be that do not focus right now on mahine mein kitna banega, main itna bana lunga, you know, because that would be the complete wrong approach to know that, achha, main agar job leta hoon yahan pe, to mujhe mahine mein 20,000 rupay, 25,000 rupay shuru mein mil jayenge. The same cheez main voicing agar experimental try karun, like, you know, Sanket also said, ki don't come here with a pastime kind of an approach, ya, you know, ye 4 ghante agar nikal ke voicing karun. If only you want to do this 100%, then you'll reach somewhere.
Yeah.
And the other thing being, see, over here you have 3 people who've establish themselves really well. I mean, I'm not undermining anybody, please don't get me wrong here, but the 3 people talking over here have really established themselves in the field. But whereas those who are still, you know, even if it's been a number of years and are still trying to, you know, reach out to studios, trying to still find work, there is a huge number of such voicing artists too. So don't think that it is going to be that easy ke kal utke main industry mein aa gaya to Neshwa ban jaungi ya main Sanket ban jaungi. It's not going to be that easy. So focus only more on learning the craft first. And rates ke baare mein main isse disclose nahi karna cha raha hu because, you know, then that would just take the mind
away. I'm not exactly asking for the exact rates. Of course, I understand that it would be different from project to project situation. Aapka kitna part hai, usme kitna time lagega us cheez ko karne mein, kitne ghante ka recording hai, wo sab sari cheeze matter karti hai. But I have seen and experience also sometimes, you know, and have got questions from the participants ki kafi baar na studios wale aapko bolte hai ki you are a beginner, to aap abhi kar lo aise hi, thoda aapka experience badhega, aap quote kar paoge ki aapne mere saath kaam kiya. Should we entertain that or should we start demanding a price?
There is a union association of voice artists.
Yes.
So any aspiring voice artist, they have a wage card, you know. Of course, wo wage card bhi abhi rework hona hai. But what I would suggest is, I think Sanket, you are also a part of the existing committee, you know. So wo wage card ke hisab se more or less ek idea aa jayega. But for that, you'll have to enroll and become a member of the association
of voice artists.
So, you know, association supports in all these things.
Yes. See, they'll give you a base rate. They'll tell you a base rate. Ki agar advertisement hai, to minimum 3,000 ya 4,000 ya whatever. There is a base rate mentioned for each and every category, each and every type of voicing. So, if possible, please follow that. Because we all do follow that.
So then I would like to know more about, for our audience, like, what is this association? How does it work and how somebody can enroll into it?
Well, anybody can enroll in the association, but it's just that they have a temporary membership and a permanent, regular membership. So, uske beech mein, I think you need to be doing 6 jobs in 1 year to be able to qualify to become a regular member. Vaise parameters hain. So, of course, and there's a website also on Association of Voice Artists. Karke, Instagram pe bhi hai, YouTube. The website is there on, easy access for anybody who wants to enroll. And in case, even if they get in touch with me or with Sanket or with Neshma, we would help out with the numbers and, you know, in case if they want to. Not a problem, they can write to us on Insta and we'll help out.
Okay, so association has streamlined all these things to ensure that everybody remains on the same page and there's no exploitation that happens for the beginners especially.
Correct.
Because what happens is many times jobs kar lete hain hum log, beginners to chodo, experienced voice artists ke saath bhi ye hota hai kai baar ke kisi dusri city mein agar production house hai wo log kar lete hain, are sir hum aapko email confirmation dena chahte hain, we are ready to, you know, this is my bank details vagera. But the moment a job is done, then sometimes even some experienced voices have not got paid. So then the association comes as a parent body, as a mother body, and, you know, protects you regarding such exploitations. So yeah, Sanket, you were saying something.
So I was kind of wanting to address the question that, so essentially speaking, what these guys are saying is absolutely true, that, you know, rates are pretty much, you know, there is a standard scale. How you get above the standard scale is you establish yourself, create a voice that is unmatched, that, you know, that requires only you the next time they need a project. And then you kind of understand that you need to now start escalating your rates. However, at the base of it, don't work for free. Who's exploiting you? Nobody's pulling you out of your house to, you know, ki recording kar le free mein, you know, mujhe bahut zaruri. Nobody's doing that to you. They are approaching you. They are telling you with whatever it is that, you know, you need to do this. Never work for free. If you're standing on a microphone, you're delivering a line, make sure that there is a value that is derived to you out of it. And the first question that you asked was how do you keep getting work? And to answer that, I would say that some of the most important conversations about you happen when you leave the room. Once you're done with your recording and you've left the room, what are the people in the room talking about you? Did they love having you there? Were you a great, fun person to be with? You took directions well, you know, you brought your own inputs to the table, you smiled, you made, you know, you cheerfully greeted everybody. Were you a good human being inside that room? Then yes, the next time they're looking for a voice artist, they're going to approach you. Were you arrogant and rude? Yeah. Did you turn up late? Did you not take directions well? Did you want to give your input over the clients? Then the next time, you know, guess what? They're not going to call you. So the way to get more and more work is to just be a better version of yourself. And, you know, you can keep doing that in slower increments every single day. That's the way I think.
So developing a professional decorum of behavior and presenting yourself well. Like, there's so many other things than just giving a voice. As he said, that you have to be there on time. You have to listen to the client. You have to greet the people properly. And these are very small, basic, simple habits. And that defines, you know, whether somebody, so if they like working with you, gradually they will invite you.
Obviously.
Yeah. Obviously. And trust me, Nancy, what I've seen over the years is there is really hardly any talent with that. If the person is having the potential, that the studios will not want to, you know, tap that artist. Every studio wants to work with somebody who has good potential, right?
Yes,
so,
of course.
Honing your talent is very, very important. And working on your craft constantly. Like, you know, पहले के ज़माने में जिस तरह से voiceovers हुआ करते थे, जी हाँ, तो अब पेश है रिन. अगर वो trend था, तो people would have to do it that way, you know. And आ गया, नया रिन was the latter stage. And now, if you look at most of the commercial and stuff, it's a very laid back, honestly. आ गया नया रिन, you know. So now, as a voice artist, I should have that ability to go with the times and to follow, you know, that kind of a format, a structured format, which is set in the minds of those top-notch creatives who are creating these, formulas. So it's ever evolving and you have to adapt to it.
Yeah.
This brings me to the next question. How can we keep learning? Are there any courses for this? Do you suggest or recommend anything? Or how can we learn from the industry experts gradually?
Yeah, there are courses like Sound and Vision.
I think except me, all my friends are teaching now. And it's a good thing, I'll say, is because they all are not just teaching, but they're sharing their experiences with all the aspiring voices. So even Sanket, you know, he's doing these 3 minutes to a better voice. Neshma is full time, you know, doing course. Rajesh Kava hai, you know, Sound and Vision, Sugar Media's, all these companies. So there's a lot of access on, you know, different courses which are there online, which they should, like Sanket said, you know, that give yourself 6 months to prepare. You know, my point being the same thing, that see, first impression being the last impression kind of a thing. So don't be in a hurry out of, to go out there and grab work and, you know, mujhe ye karna, mujhe hero banna hai or whatever. Nahin. You know, work on your talent, keep learning more. And keep checking yourself, keep assessing whether am I getting there. Slight critical hona padega aapko.
सिर्फ वीओ ही करूंगी या मैं सिर्फ एनिमेशन ही करूंगा. बहुत से लोग ऐसे आते हैं कि नहीं, आई कैन डू डिफरेंट वॉइसेज, आई कैन डू, अरे बट ये सिर्फ एनिमेशन नहीं करना, कल अगर तुम्हें मूवीज करनी है या एड्स में करना है, वीओ करना है, कुछ और करना है, सो मोल्ड योरसेल्फ दैट वे. एक ही इसमें अटक के मत रहो कि यस मैं सिर्फ इतना ही करूंगा या इतना ही करूंगी. Be versatile, explore more, learn more, and you should know the worth of your voice. तुम्हारी voice की price तुम्हें मिलती है, तो see to it that सामने वाला undue advantage ना ले. I've seen, मतलब मुझे बहुत बुरा लगा जब मैंने Facebook पर देखा, there were people who were like 150 for a voiceover for a commercial digital. I was like, what shit is happening? Yeah, 150 and 200 rupees for a 1 minute ad. So please ऐसे मत करो. बट आई कैन अंडरस्टैंड जो कर रहे हैं, जो आ रहे हैं, उनको मैं यही कहूंगी कि अपनी वॉइस की वर्थ पहचानो.
ये हो रहा है बिकॉज somebody is doing it. अगर हम करना बंद करें तो gradually it will
exactly बंद करो. नहीं बोलो नहीं मैं इतना नहीं लूंगी, मेरी वॉइस की कीमत 150 रुपया नहीं है. यू हैव द राइट टू से दैट. You should say it. नहीं मैं करूंगी, यू पे मी 1,000 rupees or यू पे मी 3,000 फॉर दैट, आई विल डू इट. Be confident. अगर तुम्हें इतनी हिम्मत है, अगर उतना टैलेंट है, उतने वर्सटाइल हो, then yes, you have the right to demand. Demand ना? मिलेगा? क्यों नहीं मिलेगा? Just because we are like, okay, ठीक है, हम करते हैं, चलो. सामने वाला एडवांटेज लेने बैठा ही है.
To add to what Neshma is saying, if what happens is have a longer vision for your career. आज अगर आप 150 में कर रहे हो ना, तो अगर उसके बाद अगर आप यू बिकम लाइक दिस अमेजिंग वॉइस आर्टिस्ट और 5 साल में देयर इज नो वन दैट कैन रिप्लेस यू इन द इंडस्ट्री एंड देन यू से कि यू नो व्हाट, आज मैं 5,000 चार्ज करूंगा, दे आर गोइंग टू टेल यू, यू नो व्हाट, 150 रुपए में करने वाले लोग हैं. यू नो हाउ इट स्टार्टेड, यू डिड इट 5 years ago, यू ब्रॉट दैट फेज इन द इंडस्ट्री. ये 150 रुपए कमा के आपको कुछ नहीं मिलेगा. यू माइट एज वेल जस्ट वर्क ऑन योर ओन सैंपल्स फॉर फ्री एट होम इंस्टेड ऑफ यू नो गेटिंग 150 फ्रॉम समबडी एल्स. They'll still be better than, you know, working for that amount of money. Respect, like she said, respect the efforts that you're putting in to learn a craft and value it like that when you're presenting it to somebody else. Very true. And this is why you should enroll in you know, workshops that people like Neshma, that, you know, Munadi or, you know, Darpan, Raju, these guys, they are amazing artists. And all of them have workshops. You know, figure out your timings, figure out how you can do them, if they're online, if they're physical, if you can't come, kya kar sakte hain. But get in touch with these guys. Yeah, they're brilliant people. And, you know, these are the things that they'll be teaching you along with, you know, how to be a better voice artist, is how to negotiate. Because as a voice artist, we are all freelancers. Hum apne accountant bhi hain, hum apne manager bhi hain. हम अपना कोऑर्डिनेशन भी खुद ही संभाल रहे हैं, हमें अपना लंच का डब्बा भी लेके जाना है और हमें पार्किंग भी ढूंढनी है गाड़ियों के लिए. यू नो, सो यू आर डूइंग एवरीथिंग फॉर योर ओन सेल्फ, योर योर ओन कंपनी. एंड दिस इज, दीज आर द स्किल्स दैट नीड टू बी टॉट, एंड दिस इज व्हाट दीस काइंड ऑफ आर्टिस्ट वर टीचिंग यू प्रोफेशनली विल ब्रिंग. सो यू नो, प्लीज एनरोल विद देम एंड यू नो लर्न फ्रॉम देम.
यू नो संकेत, द बिगेस्ट एडवांटेज फॉर एवरीबॉडी, एवरी एस्पायरिंग वॉइस आर्टिस्ट राइट नाउ इज ऑनलाइन.
Like online, absolutely.
This session which is happening, you know, each one of us is elsewhere. Reshma recently conducted one course of hers, you know, which I participated in the last day.
Right, I saw the video, right.
Everybody was from a different city, you know. It was so lovely. It was so amazing. Correct. So there's a lot of advantage which all of you all have is the digital field. You know, the digital field and scope is so much.
There are websites like Creative Live or Upgrad. So there are a lot of websites where you can kind of enroll on online classes with international voice artists as well. And it's not just for voice artists, but to be a better singer, to be, you know, how to use your voice effectively.
All the art forms, huh?
Yeah, so it's all available. The only limit is you. There is you. The only excuse is you. I mean, you just have to step out of that thing and your comfort zone and say, all right, you know, everything is available. Let me just start somewhere. You know, and just do it. Just get on the computer and start. That's all.
So and gone are the days. Mind,
yeah. Don't keep in mind that this is very easy. Main sabse pehle bol rahi hoon. It's not easy. We all three are here.
वो तो जब आप एक स्टूडियो में खड़े रहते हो ना तब पता चलता है कि कैसे होता है.
Right. Exactly. So especially because you were saying that you wanted to shift to Bombay and you know because there's a lot of good work that happens in Mumbai. There's a lot of good work that happens in Delhi. But these cities, as compared to even when I started, are very unforgiving. अगर आप वहां स्टूडियो में माइक के सामने बैठकर गलतियां करते हैं आपको अगली बार नहीं बुलाया जाएगा. हियर द मोस्ट प्रेशियस एसेट इज स्टूडियो टाइम. मैं कम से कम वक्त में कितना ज्यादा काम डिलीवर कर सकता हूं और कितने ज्यादा आर्टिस्ट अकोमोडेट कर सकता हूं, दैट इज द लुकआउट ऑफ एवरी स्टूडियो. सो व्हेन एन आर्टिस्ट टेक्स मोर टाइम देन नेसेसरी एंड इट डज इट ओवर एंड ओवर अगेन, गेस व्हाट, दे आर नॉट गोइंग टू गेट एनी मोर वर्क, स्पेशली इन सिटीज लाइक मुंबई. Yeah. But 10 years ago, phase was people would hand hold you or they would explain ki chal theek hai, ye aise kar le, ye aise kar le. Now nobody has the time and patience to do that. Very, the work has increased like tenfold, and so you know everybody is just running to finish every project immediately. People are running out of studios, and it's that kind of huge amount of work.
Yeah, absolutely.
So, so you know, that what Sankeet is indirectly trying to say is that. जो फैन डबिंग्स करते हैं वो एक सीन डब कर लेते हैं, ऑल ऑफ सडन दे फील यू नो दैट वी अराइव्ड. आई वाज स्पीकिंग इवन विद दिस आवर वेरी क्लोज फ्रेंड दर्पण एंड ही आल्सो सेड दैट आई एम फेसिंग दैट प्रॉब्लम दैट एक सीन डब कर लिया एंड दे फील के अभी तो वी क्वालिफाइंग यू नो टू डू दिस. पर वो संकेत मात्रे की एक डेडपूल के सीन के लिए अगर आप डब कर रहे हैं तो, या नेशमा की अगर ब्लैक विलो के लिए कर रहे हैं, या अंकुर जवेरी के गोकू के फैन डब कर लेते हैं, तो आप ये मत समझ लीजिए कि अब तो हम लोग जैसे स्टूडियो में जाएंगे सब लोग बोलेंगे अरे सर आप कहां थे, आप आइए. इट्स नॉट गोना हैपन दैट.
इट्स नॉट दैट. इट्स नॉट दैट व्हिच गोस इन. See, today even we have to go for auditions. We also get absolutely. Rejected. Everybody, all of us have to go for audition.
Yeah.
So that's what we, every day you have to learn so much, be perfect. Yeah.
I have one question there. So sometimes people feel that my audition got rejected. That means I am not a good voice actor. I am not good for the industry. How to take that rejection? How to deal with that?
आज नहीं हुआ तो कल हो जाएगा, बट डोंट लूज होप. इट्स ओके.
एंड अगेन आई थिंक इट डिपेंड्स ऑन रिक्वायरमेंट मोर देन योर क्वालिटी ऑफ वॉइस और समथिंग. वुड यू लाइक टू से एनीथिंग ऑन दैट?
A lot of people say that in industry mein na bahut competition hai and you know it's very difficult, and when you're going to an audition, right, the only competition is those three or two other people that have come with you. So it's just three people, utna hi competition hai. Uske alawa jo hazar artists bahar hai, that is not your competition. And the whole point is, on that day you will be judged by a person who knows the project and understands ki mujhe ye requirement hai, ye teen voices mein se I'm selecting this one. It's never a personal thing when you get rejected. It's just that on that day, for that project, that person did not deem your voice suitable amongst the three people that went there. Such a small circle. Next day, you're going for another audition and you might get selected. It's always a next day. And, you know, so taking it personally is the most foolish thing you can do for your own self. You know, never go in with that attitude.
So there was this phase, and genuinely, till 2015 or so, I was the brand voice for 32 brands. 32 brands. Now, you can't sustain that for the rest of your life, correct? There is going to be somebody who is going to be like, okay, let's try a change here. Let's do something different here. That is bound to happen. But that, do not take it as you lack the kind of craft which you think that you are holding. But keeping that in mind, we come back to that same thing. Okay? Try increasing your bandwidth, try increasing your range. So that even if, let's say, one category of work you're not being able to make it there, you know the other kind of textures and voices and feels and emotions to, you know, be able to do other stuff.
Correct.
So be an actor in a true sense, so that you, if not this, you can do this one. If not this, you can do that one. If not this project, the another project. If not today, then tomorrow.
Correct.
Be versatile. Be versatile. That's very important.
True. Okay, I think we have covered so many things. It's been, oh my God, it's almost 9 o'clock right now. Anything that we might have missed or anything that you want to add personally, like any three of you, would you like to add on something to what all we have discussed? I think I've tried covering almost all the questions that were asked by the different participants. If we are missing on anything, or if you want to say anything or add anything, please do.
in case if you all want to know a little more about how the field works and, you know, how the interactions are and learn more, then please be a part of this fest, which is coming up in December called India Voice Fest.
India Voice.
We all are going to be a part of it. And we thoroughly enjoy, you know, somewhere. All,
so what is it? Can you brief a little more about that?
So, Sanket, yeah, in case you don't know.
So India Voice Fest is a platform that is created by Darpan Mehta from Sugar Medias, and he is ably supported by a lot of prominent studios like Sound and Vision, Audio Magic, and a lot of other guys from the industry. And the festival is a series of sessions which constitute of directors talking about the craft, artists talking about different skills. There are master classes done by legendary performers like Harish Bhimani ji has been a part of it, and, you know, so Chetan Sashital ji has been a part of it. And alongside that, there is a very important thing which is done every year, which is like a talent hunt which happens, where an open platform is provided where you send entries, and there's a vast jury of about 16 to 20 prominent not only artists, but people from the technical field, studio owners, directors, and they form this huge jury which kind of selects and shortlists these talents which are coming in. Then they are given a chance to perform, and they are given real world opportunities from the industry. So they will be given work in the industry once they kind of crack the talent hunt. And so this is a huge huge deal, not only for aspiring voice artists, but for us as well, because sitting down to listen to how a Chetan Sashital approaches a project or how Mr. Harish Bhimani approaches a project is not something we get to hear every day as well. So it's a treat for everyone, especially if you're passionate about voices and want to, hear people talk about first-hand experiences. And at the end of it, there's also this kind of awards thing that happens, which is unique to our industry, which has not happened before, which is like the Voice Awards, where us artists kind of send in our nominations for different categories, a bunch of categories that Ankur spoke of earlier. A lot of those categories are there, and we send our nominations, and then this jury kind of selects. So even if you are aspiring today and you become a voiceover artist, tomorrow, 2 years down the line, you could be sending entries to your, the next India Voice Fest that's happening. So please be a part of it. Like you said, it's truly a good entryway or a gateway to understand what the industry is in, a period of 7 days, watching all the sessions on. And it's online, so you don't have to kind of go anywhere as well.
And again, you get to know people in the industry, you can learn from that, you can connect, and you can understand like what are the different variety of work people are doing and learn from the experts.
Absolutely.
Also.
Yeah, absolutely.
And to add to that, Neshma Chimburkar is a double award winner in the very first year of India Voice Fest.
Even Sanket Matre and even Ankur Zaveriko, Nancy, all the three of us have been awarded from past 2 years. Right?
Yes. In fact, so I should not say this, but when I got through your introductions, there were so many things. I had to cut down a few just to fit into the timeline. But there were so many things. This award, that award, this movie, that movie, this character, that character. Then, oh my God, these guys have just done it like amazingly. So with this, I want to ask one question. Sorry, Raha nahi ja raha hai. That is ki, see, your personal life is totally different than your voice acting life. Sometimes you have a good mood, sometimes you don't have a good mood, sometimes you are feeling well, sometimes not. Not all days are same, no? But when you enter the studio, you have to perform at the best. How do you balance this?
Yehi toh jadoo hai. When we put the headphones and we sit in front of the mic, the magic flows out. We just forget everything. Absolutely. We just forget everything. And we are in a different, some different world. Someday you're a queen, someday you're a witch, someday you're a boy, someday you're a girl. It's totally different. I remember I worked in bank for, I was a banker for 7 years. But I felt the job was so monotonous. The versatility here is so nice. I mean, I really love this job so much, this profession, that I had decided then and there, ki after marriage, I'm going to be a full-time voiceover artist. That's it. Nothing else. Nothing doing.
So and this one, you had taken a gap also, right? During a... and yet you managed to come back. So she's taking... So Neshma took...
No, gaps as in dubbing se kabhi gap nahi mila.
But motherhood, yeah. Motherhood, yeah.
मुझे बेड रेस्ट था बट दैट टाइम आल्सो आई यूज्ड टू गो टू हमिद स्टूडियो एंड इतने प्यार से मुझे वो लोग बुलाते थे एंड यू नो इतनी खातिरदारी करते
सो दिस इज अ मैसेज इफ एट ऑल यू आर अ फीमेल इफ एट ऑल यू आर हैविंग योर डिफरेंट स्टेजेस ऑफ लाइफ साइकिल यू विल बी एबल टू कंटिन्यू विद दिस करियर
Yes, absolutely. I think this is the only field where you have the freedom to say, no, I can't come today. I'm so sorry. Bank mein, any office, you know, you have to sick leave, de do, ya ye leave, wo leaves hote hain, phir bhi chutti nahi dete. So this was the only field, okay, kya hoga? Zyada se zyada, aaj ka mera kaam jayega. That's it. I can say, nahi, aaj mujhe nahi aana hai. Bas aaj mere bete ka birthday, ya, aaj mujhe nahi karna hai, bas. You have the freedom to say, no, I'm not coming today. Nobody's going to force you, come.
Yeah.
So I feel
so you choose especially. What you want to do and you choose your timings, you choose your days and you're your own boss and manager.
You are your own boss. Very true. Absolutely. You're your own
and
boss.
And you get this privilege.
Yeah.
But yes, of course, it comes along with a certain limitation.
Yeah, absolutely. Because salary nahi aati end mein. That's a very important thing.
Yes. So
freelancer, it comes along with a responsibility.
कभी सालों भी लग जाते हैं संकेत 3 महीने क्या
3 महीना डिड आई हियर राइट हेलो कुछ
गड़बड़ या दैट्स द बिगेस्ट प्रॉब्लम सिर्फ एक ही
चीज देयर आर प्रोस एंड कॉन्स बट या
पेमेंट टाइम पे नहीं होती जैसे इट्स नॉट लाइक सैलरी आपकी एवरी 27th ऑफ द मंथ आती है इट्स नॉट लाइक दैट सो इट्स अ रोलिंग
प्रोडक्शन हाउसेस आर वेरी गुड लेट्स से 10% और 15% ऑफ देम आर एक्सट्रीमली प्रॉम्प्ट But the other 80-85%, we have to deal with them differently.
You have to be your own manager and call them up and say, paisa do, whatever.
So you have to give follow-ups, you have to give reminders, you have to ensure that you are paid exactly what was quoted and you have to ensure that it is done in a right manner, in a right time.
And jab aisa nahi hota, then AVA comes. Then the parent body is there to help us.
So I will suggest that's why you should be part of association.
I will always suggest please become a member of the association if you want to be in this field because they are the parent body. They are going to help us.
So you get a mentor there. You get somebody to look after you. If there is any cheating, if there is anything wrong, you can go and tell it to somebody.
Very
See, main apne ghar pe bhi bata sakti hu, par mere ghar wale kuch kar nahi payenge uske bare mein.
Correct.
But if I go and tell it to the association would be able to take steps for the same, no?
Absolutely.
And they have taken steps. They have taken. Yeah. Many such examples are there.
बहुत बड़े बड़े नाम नहीं लेना चाहूंगा बट बहुत बड़े बड़े प्रोडक्शन हाउसेज में छोटे छोटे आर्टिस्ट के भी अगर पैसे अटके हुए होते थे ना तो उससे भी एसोसिएशन ने बहुत डिलिजेंटली यू नो उनके पीछे लग के छोटे आर्टिस्ट को भी अपना हक दिलवाया सो दे हैव डन अमेजिंग जॉब
Okay. Last question before we go. I know I have taken more than the scheduled time, but I was expecting this because all three of you were there. And we still have 100 people who are watching us right now. Can we have a round of applause for all of the participants who have been here? It's amazing response that we are getting it from you and that's why we are even extending, we are doing and these guys are still here. Last question, is there any age from where only you should start? You can be a child actor also or what do you say about this?
There's no age limit. I said. See, I started at the age of 4, my son started at the age of 2.5. वो बहुत जल्दी बोलने लगा था एंड हिज फर्स्ट प्रोजेक्ट वाज विद एली तो देयर इज नो एज लिमिट एज सच बट यस द क्लैरिटी द डिक्शन द प्रोनंसिएशन जो भी एसेंशियल्स हैं वो अगर आप में है तो यू कैन स्टार्ट एट एनी एज कुछ बोलना था मॉन्स्टर इंक के लिए गया था मम्मी नहीं वो अच्छा बोलता था
So in a field where
female voice artists can voice for Chota Bheem, age is really, you know, just a number. It's irrelevant completely in an industry where the same artist can produce a baby's laughing sound as well as a grandmother's crying sound. You know, totally depends on what your vocal range is. So your age on when to start or your age of what you can voice for is up to you. There's really no entry point in the industry. Absolutely not.
But then if you perform well, then there is endless. That is really
sky absolutely. Is the limit for you. Sky absolutely. Is the limit for you.
Absolutely.
But do the variety of work, explore yourself, add emotion, develop professional behavior. These are my takeaways from today's session. What you have said, be part of the association and learn from experts. Be part of the India Voice Fest that is happening in December
this
year. And gradually. So I think it is a time-taking process. If you are thinking that I'll start from tomorrow and I'll be famous in a week or month or year, it's not going to happen that way. You have
then
to
please let me know the formula. Then please let me know the formula. I'm trying since 37 years.
No, thank you so much to all three of you for being here. जाने से पहले एक छोटा सा हम कुछ role play जैसा कर सकते हैं. Like we have Ben 10, we have Chiji, we have Goku here. We can't let you go without this. So just anything like if you can give it together or play something because people are demanding there in the chat box. Everybody is shouting out for this.
Yeah, I'll try Ben 10.
Okay, yeah, please Sankit sir.
हाय, मेरा नाम बेन है, बेन टेनिसन, और मुझे स्पीकर सर्कल का शुक्रिया अदा करना है कि उन्होंने मुझे इस सेशन में गोकू और चीची के साथ बुलाया. बहुत बहुत शुक्रिया.
हाय गैजेट, हाय
गैजेट,
गोकू एंड चीची टुगेदर.
या
गोकू, ये कोई टाइम है घर आने का? ये कोई समय है घर आने का? मुझे कितना काम करना पड़ता है? गोहान की पढ़ाई लेनी पड़ती है, गोटेन की बस चीची की keeps on shouting.
So you remember you had also I think one question where how do you maintain an angry voice kind of a thing. So Goku is such a character, he fights with the worst of the villains, but the biggest villain, or rather I would not say villain, the only person whom he can't defeat ever is Chichi.
You know, we still call each other Goku and Chichi. Whenever we meet, we still call. I call Ankur Goku and he calls me Chichi. Yeah, some lines of Goku, Ankur.
In way.
Dunya sunna chahti hai.
It's only 9:17 people. Okay, we can,
we can do the Power Rangers stuff. I suppose we three were there in Power Rangers. Yeah, even Sanket was there, right?
Yeah. Red Ranger.
Sanket was Red Ranger later on, yeah.
Yeah.
Achha, initially we would. I suppose I have worked with both of y'all.
Both of yeah.
In Power Rangers. So come on, Dino Thunder, power up, ha!
Ha! Ha!
My goodness.
See the amount.
But
of
honestly, thank you so much, yeah, Nancy. Yeah. It's such a rare occasion to be able to sit across and speak to even Neshma and Ankur like this, and you know. Yeah. Get to hear of their experience. This is exactly what I mean by, you know, India Voice Fest, where you can just sit and listen to these guys because, you know, the kind of project that they worked on and the kind of equipment that they worked on requires a lot of skill. We have it quite easy with computers now. They've been working around with equipment that made you say, if you missed a line, you have to say the entire chunk again, you know, so those.
Yeah.
The kind of skill you need to bring to the table is immense. So to be able to hear them was great. So, you know, I was almost like a fan who's watching with the chat, you know, as to what their experiences were. So thank you so much, Nancy, and thank you, Peter.
Thank you,
Sanket.
And Nancy, the India Voice Fest is a 7-day, fest. So starting on the 5th of December, going all the way till 11th of December. And it's a very nominal fee for registration. But the kind of learning, you know, like which the three of us have been talking to you about, it's immense. It's immense. For every aspiring voice artist must be a part of India Voice Fest. India. Must register now.
And it's online. It's online.
Yeah, it's online. It is the only platform created by a voice artist for a voice artist.
Correct.
So it's
they're working
great.
Very hard here. They're working very hard for
absolutely.
So, 5th so December much. To 11th December, yes. Online India Voice Fest. You should register for it. You'll find the details. Just Google it out. You will get it for sure.
Yeah.
For sure. And yes, do follow these guys. You can follow Sanket Madre, Nishma Chimburkar, and Ankur Zaveri on their social media handles. They keep conducting such sessions, and I'm sure you'll be able to attend most of them. And some of them are free also. So, you know.
I think Nancy has attended one of the workshops, right?
Yes. That's why how I got to connect with you, and then I saw about Sanket sir, and you suggested Ankur sir, and finally we are keeping this session together. We have been live for 1 hour and 38 minutes and we still have 97 participants watching us. This is a very big achievement. Thank you so much, everybody, for being here. More than happy to have you all the speakers, all the participants. Thank you for bringing such wonderful discussion to the table. It is much required, because there are so many people who want to get into this field but have no idea about it. And this was the main purpose, that we spread awareness from the right person who has already done something remarkable in the industry. And we are so happy that we could have three of you here together for this session, and we rocked it like anything. A big round of applause to all the speakers that we had. Thanks to Nishma Chepulka, Ankur Zaveri, Sanket Madre sir, and all those participants who have been here for the entire session.
Thank you, Nancy. Thank you, so thank you, Sanket. Thank you, Ankur. And thank you, everyone. Thank you. Thanks for loving us. All the fans for loving us, for loving our voice. Thank you so much. Thank you, Nancy. Thank you. And speaker circle. Yes.
We are always there, and we will keep conducting such session and keep inviting you.
Thank you for being here.
Thank you.
So that was it. How did you like it? Feel free to share your thoughts in the chat section. If you want to know more about them, you can follow them on their social media handles. Feel free to learn. These guys are having a remarkable experience in the industry, and that's the reason why we have invited them here. We're so happy to have all of them here. And at the same time, all the participants who have been watching us throughout the session, I hope you enjoyed, found something helpful. If I summarize the entire conversation, like it's been 1.5 hour, more than 1.5 hour now, if I summarize the entire conversation, I would say that first thing about becoming a voice actor, work upon your language, learn your pronunciation, have patience, create good samples, create your voice recording samples, go to the studio, approach them, build relationships with people, ensure that you are able to connect and set your benchmark in the industry gradually. It is not going to have an overnight magic. Do not expect that. Have patience, work continuously, try different variety of work. It's not only about dubbing films. It's not only about giving your voice into the advertisement. There is a lot more, like Ankur sir just read out the list in front of you. Be part of the association, the voicing association, where you'll get help, you'll get mentors, you'll get guidance, you'll get base rates and wages through which you can quote your price. And if you have any queries, you can approach them. Attend the Voice Fest, which is happening from 5th to 11th of December. It is online, and there are nominal charges for it, but it is a wonderful learning experience, and I'm surely going to be part of it. And there are many more things that they have discussed. I am overwhelmed with the response that we have got through the speakers, their response on all the questions, and response that we have got from the participants. Thank you so much for being here. And yes, do not forget, we are going to have three more sessions like this, where we are going to talk about three different industries. Tomorrow, we are going to have RJ Parima. She works with Radio Mirchi 98.3 FM Surat, and she's going to talk about how we can build a career as an RJ, and then another two sessions coming up for you. So be there tomorrow, 7:30 p.m. for this particular YouTube channel, where Speaker Circle is inviting different speakers from different industry to talk about how you can build a career into this. If you have any questions, queries, feel free to reach out or drop a message. We will surely try to help you in whatever manner we can. And this is Nancy Shah signing off. If you have not subscribed this YouTube channel, do it now so that you do not miss any sessions. Thank you for joining, everybody. Had a great time with you all. Good night and bye-bye.